Hi everyone, Matthew from CELT here one more time. So if you've been following along in our Faculty Friday session, you've probably seen how we've had a real-time graph that's changed. And what that looks like is you can see our graph right here. It doesn't have any information in it right now. But what we should have seen, hopefully, while we were participating together inside of the workshop, is we should see something like this start to happen as we're collecting some sample data from our group. And this is a pretty cool trick, and it's something that anyone can do using Google Spreadsheets, and I'd like to show you what's actually happening here so you can understand how to replicate this very same principle on your own. So this graph here inside of Google Docs is actually running off of a spreadsheet, or another part of the spreadsheet, I should say, that's actually here on one of these other pages of our workbook. So what I did to start out with is I went ahead and figured out what questions I wanted to ask. So here you can see that here are the questions that we talked about. And here are the values that we have that everyone has called out. And what's happening is I've used an average formula right here. So you can see equals average and then cells A5 through A30. So it's looking at this cell right here, 5 through 30. I was guessing we weren't going to have more than 30 participants. And if I needed to change that formula, I always could. So this seemed like a good place to start. So what I did next is I used another page here inside of my workbook to pull all of that data together. So here I've got the same questions repeated, and you can see right here I've actually referenced A4, this cell right here. Ba-dum. It's on another page. And you can tell that it's on another page because here it says questions, that's the name of the page of the workbook. A4 is the name of the cell, and it's pulling that value right over here into this table. And the reason that's important is because what I did is I just highlighted these six cells right here, and I clicked right here on this chart button, and this allowed me to create a chart nice and simply and easily from the data that we've collected. Now you can see here the scale is a little bit off. It actually really explodes the differences between our two groups here, even though our numbers aren't too far apart. So if we go into customization right here, or customize this little tab, we can actually set the minimum. In this case, I'm going to make the minimum 0 and the maximum 10. And now we can see that those are much closer. I could also change the color here, give it a title, do lots of exciting things. So I hope this gives you an idea of how this chart's working. Once I wanted to put it into a page, what I did is I hit this little insert button right here. And then you can move it around, or you can use this little button right here to move it to its own page. I hope this gives you an idea of how I made this chart and what's actually happening behind the scenes as we're using this in our presentation. Have a great day, everybody. Thanks.